Now let's take on the question number 16. Question number 16 is a matrix match type of question. Here it is. A charged particle with some initial velocity is projected in a region where electric and magnetic fields are present. Column 1 contains description of magnetic field and electric field and velocity. Match the entries of column 1 with those of column 2. In column 2, characteristic of the motion or how the path will be followed by the particles are given. Now let's start with the option A here. In option A, electric field is 0 and magnetic field is not equal to 0. And initial velocity is at acute angle with B. It's a very simplistic kind of questions. This is the magnetic field and the particle starts along some direction. So I would say one component of the velocity will be along the direction of magnetic field and other being perpendicular to it. So because of the perpendicular component, the particle will execute the circular path, and because of aligned component, it will traverse along the direction of magnetic field. So effectively, the particle will execute a helical path and its speed will remain unchanged. So for option A, here the matching Q and the T. The correct matching is Q and T. Q is path followed by the particle is helical and T is the speed of the particle remains unchanged. For option B, electric field is not equal to 0 and magnetic field is 0. Electric field is not equal to 0 and magnetic field is 0. Initial velocity is at acute angle. That means the particle will now be moving under the constant acceleration and so it will follow a parabolic path and its speed will increase. So my answer here is for the option B, option R and option S is the correct matching. R and S is the correct matching. R says path followed by the particle is parabolic and S is speed of the particle will increase. Now let's see the option C. Electric field and magnetic field both are not zero and both are along same direction. And initial velocity is perpendicular to both. That means because of the magnetic field, the particle will try to execute the circular motion, and because of electric field, its speed will increase along the direction of electric field. So I would say the particle will follow the helical path. So option Q is the correct answer, and its pitch length will keep on increasing because of increasing speed. And the option S here, speed of the particle will increase, is also the correct matching. So for the option C, Q and S is the correct matching. Now for the option D, electric field is not zero and magnetic field is also not zero, and V naught cross B, it's been given to be minus E naught. This is exactly the situation where the magnetic field's effect would be cancelled out. In fact, the force because of magnetic field would be cancelled out and counterbalanced by the force because of electric field. So in such case, the particle will follow the straight line path. It will move unaccelerated and undeviated, and the particle's speed will remain unchanged. So for the option D, P and T is the correct matching. So here we got the answer as for the option A, we got Q and T is the correct matching. For option B, we got R and S as the correct matching. For option C, we got Q and S as the correct matching. And for option D, we got P and T as the correct matching. That's the answer for the question number 16. Now let's take on to the question number 17 here. It is the matrix match type of questions wherein column 1 contains the configuration of current carrying loops. Column 2 contains the magnitude of magnetic field at the point P. Point P being the almost central point or the geometrical center, you may say, in the three different parts. Match the entries of the column 1 with those of the column 2. Well, let's take on with the question number 1 itself, that is the magnetic field at the central point of the square frame. So here the magnetic field, I would say, for the first part, it is mu naught I divided by 4 pi. This being the distance d, it is a by 2, and this angle is 45, so it is 2 into cos 45 1 by root 2. This is the magnetic field because of this one segment here. There are 4 such different segments, so the total resulting magnetic field would be 4 times of this one. So this 4 will cancel out. I will have the answer here as 2 root 2 mu naught I divide by pi A. This is the magnetic field at the central point. So for option A, my answer is T is the correct matching. This is the answer for option A. Now let's see the question number B. This is the regular or equilateral triangular part. So the magnetic field at this point will be, again the calculation procedure is same as we have calculated here. I need to find out the magnetic field because of one segment. It is mu naught I divided by 4 pi d. This is the d this time. It will come out to be this portion being root 3 a by 2 and divide by 3. So it is a divided by 2 root 3. This is the value of the d here. So this angle here, it is 30 degree. 2 into cos 30, it is root 3 by 2. And this time there are 3 such segments. So these two will cancel out and 2 here. So I will have 9 mu naught I divided by 2 pi A. This is the effective magnetic field at its central point P. So for the option B, my answer is S. S is the correct matching here. Now let's see how the option C would be. In option C, this is the infinitely extending wire and this is also the infinitely extending wire. So magnetic field at this point would be, it is mu naught I divided by 2 pi d being a here, and plus I would say magnetic field because of this semicircular portion of the wire here. One complete circular portion would have the magnetic field mu naught I by 2 a. So the semicircle will have the magnetic mu naught I divided by 4 a. So taking the sum of this part, I'll get the answer as mu naught I divided by 4 pi a 2 plus pi. So because of this portion, the magnetic field at the central point P would be mu naught I divided by 4 pi a and multiplied into pi plus 2. So for the option number C, my correct matching is R. Now I need to find out how the magnetic field at the central point would be because of this hexagonal structure. Calculation method would be again same. So I would say here, mu naught I divide by, this is the d this time, it is 4 pi, d being root 3 a by 2, it is root 3 a into 2. This angle is 60 degree, 2 into cos 60, it will be 1, and there are 6 such segments. So 2 here, this is 3, root 3, so I would say root 3 mu naught I divide by pi a. This is the magnetic field at the central point at its center. So my answer here for the option number D, Q is the correct matching. So what we got here, we got for the option A, T is the correct matching. For the option B, S is the correct matching. For the option C, R is the correct matching. And for the option D, Q is the correct matching. That's the answer for the question number 17. Now let's take on to the question number 18.